Here are four simple yet super effective ways to make your footage more cinematic. So the first tip for more cinematic videos is to add a letterbox to your video. And you can simply do that by going to the top left of your screen to where you see timeline, then go all the way down to where it says output blanking, and then just choose the aspect ratio that you like. And in this case, it's 2.4:1. And right off the bat, we can see that we have those cinematic black bars at the bottom and at the top of our shot. But doing it this way, you still have the flexibility to manually reframe your shot in post. And what I mean by that is I'm going to select my shot, go to the top right of the screen to where it says inspector, and then go to position Y, and I'm just going to drag down my shot to manually reframe it. Let's go with something like this. But now let's take a look at the second shot, and we can see that the framing is off as well. So I'm just going to select it and do the exact same thing. Just reframe it until I'm happy with. So tip number two are actually two effects packed into one. And to showcase them best, let's hop into the color page. And from here, you can see that there's nothing special going on, just a regular, like, small color grading. However, I'm going to add a new node by hitting Alt and S to create a new serial node. And on this node, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to go over to my effects panel, go down to where you see glow, and drag the glow effect onto the node number 6. And by default, nothing really has changed except it made the bright parts even brighter. But that's not what we want to do. So first of all, we're going to go over to effects panel, and down where you see composite type, you want to change that from add to soft light. And by default, this is giving us a way more contrasty, way more pleasing cinematic image. However, we can also increase that just a little bit more by increasing our shine threshold just a little bit, and then increasing the spread a bit, increasing our gain just a little bit more, and then we can increase the opacity to make that effect even crazier. Something like that is looking perfect to me. And if you want to blend this in a little bit better, you can use the blend slider. However, there's one more effect that I want to talk about, and let's hop over to our first shot, which is this one right here. And as you can see, we have our node number 5 deactivated. If I'm going to activate this, this will give you some light rays, or god rays as they are also known as. However, let's just delete that node and gonna replicate this by again creating a new node by hitting Alt and S to create a new node. Then go over to your effects panel, choose the light rays effect, drag it onto node number 5. And by default, this is giving us a horrible effect. The first step that I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna increase my threshold all the way. Something like that is looking pretty good. Then I wanna change the light rays position from a location down to at an angle. You can leave that at from a location, however. So second step is I'm gonna change the length and make them even longer. Something like this. Then I'm gonna make them more soft. And then I can give them a color to match the scene. Let's go with something very warm. And let's just have a look. This looks super good. But if we change that from location to at an angle, we have even more control. We can choose the angle that the light rays should appear on screen. Let's go with something like this. Make them even longer and maybe increase the brightness just a little bit. So we have very, very pleasing light rays in our image with just one simple effect. But if you want even more effects that will help you make better videos faster, I highly recommend you to check out Motion VFX, because they are doing a Black Week sale starting as of today, November 7th until December the 4th. And they are giving you 30% off of everything except bundles using the code BLACK30 at checkout. Motion VFX is a service that I use in every project, whether this is on my YouTube channel right here or for clients. I'm always using some stuff from Motion VFX in any way, shape, or form for my videos, because they make it super easy to create better videos faster. So if you're interested in Motion VFX, click the link in the description to save yourself 30% on your favorite plugin using the code BLACK30 at checkout. But now let's continue with tip number three. So tip number three is to add motion blur to your shots. And as you can see within this shot, I'm flying very close to the ground, and I didn't bring any ND filter with my drone. So if you take a look at this region, there should be motion blur. However, my shutter speed was probably way higher than the Burj Khalifa, so there is absolutely no motion blur in the shot whatsoever. So, and in order to fix that, if you have the studio version, you can just simply go down until you see this motion effects panel and just increase the motion blur slider to get some motion blur. And as you can see, the bottom part gets a lot more blurry. And if we play this back, you can see we now have a lot motion blur going on, which is pretty good. However, I know that probably not all of you have the studio version, so we're gonna reset that. And what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna jump over to the Fusion page. So the first note that we're gonna add is the optical flow node. So select media in one, hit shift spacebar and type in optical flow. Add the optical flow node, and what this does is it analyzes the image based on what is moving in the shot. And the second note that we're gonna add is the vector motion blur. However, take a look at this bottom part right here. Then what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to hit shift spacebar and type in vector and add the vector motion blur. And now just by doing nothing, take a look at the bottom. It got way more blurry, and you can fine tune that by going over to your inspector in the top right corner, change the scale. I wouldn't go past 1.9 or 2 because 1.9 is giving you crazy motion blur, as you can see in the grass right here. Because if I'm going to reset that, you can see that there's basically no motion blur going on. But if I'm going to crank that up to 1.9, it takes a while to render. But now you can see there's a crazy bunch of motion blur going on. Tip number 4 is, with all of this done, we have a very, very pleasing image. However, there's still something missing. So what we can do is add some light leak overlays. And if you don't have any, don't be afraid. Just type in Google light leak overlays free, or type it into YouTube, and I'm sure you can get some free ones. Then what you want to do is drag them in your media pool, as you can see right here. And let's just use this one. Drag it on top of your footage, just like so. And right now we can only see the light leaks because we have to make some changes. So select the light leaks, go to the top right of your screen to where you see inspector, go down to composite and change the composite mode from normal to screen. And right now, this effect is a little bit too harsh for my liking, so I'm going to reduce the opacity to around 40%. And as you can see, we now have those subtle light leaks, which make a crazy cinematic image. And let's take a look. On our second shot, we have some light leaks over here on this part. But, you know, if you want it to be more visible on a second image, you can also just increase that to make them a lot more visible. So that's my 4 top tips to make your videos more cinematic. So that's a wrap. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If so, please consider leaving a like, because that would help a ton. But anyways, hope you're having a great day. See you next time. Bye.